la la. A young lad, young Jordan, is a you tell them.
No, no drop no guard on me, girl, me analyze. Member, say you nail them drive to the undercross. Man never drop guard, Jenna seen thing, man a top dog.
So guys, welcome back to another video here on Lucia's Life. You know how it is, you know what it do. If you're new here, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Welcome to the channel, mwah, I love you guys so much. Today we're going to be doing a get ready with me. I know I haven't filmed and I know y'all might be waiting on another podcast, but I am gonna do suggested topics for that as well. So if you want to be a part of that, follow my Instagram. It should be on the screen right there. Please don't mind my face, like I just got up and thought, right, time to like film, like. So we're gonna be doing a makeup look. I will insert the picture here. I got it on Pinterest. And I'm gonna be answering some questions. My phone is dead and it's on charge, so I wrote the questions down. Well, some of them, I wrote some of the questions down. And my big mirror is at the back of me over there, so I'm gonna be using my double-sided mirror to like see, but y'all, I will zoom in. Any parts where I'm not talking, just enjoy the routine, I guess. A little bit of get to know me, get ready with me, whatever the hell you want to call it. But like I said, if you're new here, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I love you guys so much, and let's get into today's video. First off, I am going to moisturize my face. This is a dermalogical cream, not by Dermalogica. This is not sponsored. My dad gets these from the hospital. They're actually really, really good for your skin, and I use these sometimes because, as you can say, like I have a like acne scarring and stuff like that. And yeah, I've been trying to get rid of like these dark marks and stuff. It's actually really hard because my skin is combination skin, and it's like proper sensitive. Like you could scratch me and I'll get a mark and it will stay there for so long. It's like unbelievable. Okay, so the first thing we're going to start off with is my foundation. I used to use Dream Urban Cover by Maybelline New York SP50, but this shade was a bit too dark for me, and the they sell it for cheaper up Sutton, if you know. You were Birmingham baby. Is Birmingham the right term? Is Birmingham? It's up Sutton, right? And they do it for cheaper. So I need to go up there and get the foundation. But for now, we're going to be mixing foundations. I'm going to be using the Perfect Finish Foundation by PS. Yes, this is a Primark foundation, but it actually really matches my skin tone. I'm like, good on you, Primark. This is the Perfect Finish Foundation. This is the colour. I think this is sand.
Shut up. Get out of this channel, mate. Get
out of here.
The first question is, if you could change one thing that has happened to you, what would it be? If I could change one thing that's happened to me. You know what? To be honest, I actually don't know. Like, one thing that's happened to me that I could change, I'd probably say there's more than one. Guys, please don't judge me how I do my makeup. Like, I literally just do it different to depending on like how I'm feeling on that day. And I'll just be like, guess how we do. But what would I change? I'd probably change like maybe the people I'm hanging around with. I was quite the person to like tend to want to have a lot of friends, and obviously as I was growing up, you kind of realize like you don't need too many friends in your circle, which is a thing that when you're in like primary school and secondary school and stuff, you kind of like I don't know, like you kind of like want that, like you expect it, like it's like a thing where you're just like, oh, I'm gonna need a lot of friends, like, because when you're in different lessons and say you've got like five friends or whatever and they're not in your class, they like, you feel a little bit like, do you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. I don't know how to explain it. Let me know in the comments, yeah, if you guys know what I'm saying. It does look a little bit pale, guys, but I promise you it will get better. I always think this, like, when I first started using this foundation, I was just like, okay, it's up the wrong colour. But then I did the rest of my routine, and it actually came out really nice. So, just wait. I'm trusting, believing the process, guys. Trusting, believing the process. For anybody asking, the instrumental in the back is Bump On It by Hood Celebrity. I actually really really love this song. I've heard it from my sister and my cousins, like they've played it, and I just thought I gotta get the song. A lot of people don't use brushes. This brush really needs washing, like, oh my god. But yeah, okay, so the next question is my birthday. I am born on the 8th of May 2002. That's when I was born. I love my birthday. Like, what? The 8th of May? Like, the 8th. And the thing is, my favorite number is 8 as well. It's just a bonus. Shocked, because this is literally finished, and every time I give it a good old knock, I don't know guys if you can see, but stuff actually comes out, and I'm just like, what? Stuff actually comes out, and I'm just like, what?
Stuff actually comes out, and I'm just like, what?
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Guys, I don't know if you can tell, but it's like kind of warming out the color a bit. So yeah, I am one of those persons I don't like to mix my foundations. The next question is my age. I am 17, guys. 17 years old. I'm turning 18, obviously, May coming. If you are friends or you want to roll and you know me or you in the area, I might be having a joint birthday party if it happens. I'm a very broke kid, let's be honest. Like, no cap on this channel, I'm a very broke kid. So if we find a venue that is within my budget, then we can see what gonna happen, what we gonna do. But yeah guys, you know what, I am like super sorry that I don't record at least once a week. I'm gonna try and start doing that. Speaking on like birthdays and stuff like that, I am a Taurus. The question is literally, what's your star sign? I'm a Taurus, guys. I'm born 8th of May, like I said. And if you are a Taurus, yeah, comment down below. Taurus gang, 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 gang. We are massive procrastinators. Like, we are massive procrastinators. I think so anyway, because like, I want to do, I'm so like inspired to do something when I'm like, I don't know, around people that want to do it as well. I like to do things in groups. I don't like to like be by myself, do you know what I mean? I just don't see the point. I think it's like, when you're doing stuff with people, you're not like a single voice, and then that's when you kind of get into it. My full name, that's the next question. My full name is Miracle Lucia Attride Blake, and then when I get older I am going to put my dad's surname on the end. I am going to put my dad's surname on the end. Yes guys, relating to that, the next question is, how many siblings have you got? I don't, like, kill me if this is wrong, but I think I have 18 or 14 to be. You're probably like, white girl, like what? No, we're not gonna do that. That's what we're not gonna do. Have a big family, and I am the last kid out of both sides. Most of my siblings are from my dad's side, and to be fair, I'm actually glad that I have a big family. I don't know all my siblings. So if you put it into perspective, I have 8 siblings. 4 on my mom's side, I'm the 4th on both sides. No, I'm the 5th on my dad's side, and the 4th on my mom's side. I have 2 brothers and 1 sister on my mom's side. And I have 2 brothers and 2 sisters on my dad's side. And I'm the youngest from both sides. Obviously, I have more siblings, but like I said, I don't know all of them. Backstory: my dad gave me the name Miracle when I was born. My stepdad. And my mom was going to call me Lucia because she wanted to go for something a bit authentic. I get different, I guess you could say. And my dad was like, that's a really nice name, why don't we also call him Miracle though, because you was told that you can't have any more kids. My mom was actually quite of age when she had me, and they told her that she can't have no more kids, and then I came along, little old me, do you know what I mean? So, but yeah, so that's it. The next question is my favorite song. Guys, to be honest, my favorite song at the moment is literally Bomb Panic by Hood Celebrity. I have been playing this song, yeah, since I heard it. Like, it's been on repeat. It's actually really bad. My field of study, I study beauty at college. I am doing level 1. And I'm gonna drag that down to one of the questions on here, which is life goals. One life goal that I have is I want to open up my own nail salon. And if you guys want me to do a video on like business, I guess, I think I've done this, I've asked this before, but people don't really get back to you when you don't have a lot of subscribers. But I might film a video on business. But yeah, so guys, basically my field of study is beauty, and leading down to one of the questions, which is life goals, I do want to open up a nail salon. I do want to go big on YouTube, and one of my goals is to like make people smile. I guess you could say it's like a purpose. I feel like I want to like proceed. Is that the word? Proceed. Can you guys even see it? Like, I can't feel like. I can see it, but I don't know if you can see it. And I don't want to contour too much because, like, we're not doing that right now. We're not going to do the contouring. And do you know how we're not going to do it? Because, honey, we don't have time. We don't have time, yeah? Guys, I kind of contour my head just because I don't want my head to look like enormous. You know what I mean? And then I kind of contour like whatever is left on the brush, like underneath my double chin. There is, I can feel fur on my face, guys. I feel it, like, oh my god. Okay guys, hold up, I'll be right back. Okay guys, I'm back. I just sorted out the music because it was really like helping me get through this video. The next question is ideal partner. What's my ideal partner? My ideal partner is someone who can make me laugh, or someone who loves to laugh. Like, when I mean like someone who loves to laugh, I mean like literally someone who loves to laugh, because I am always laughing. Like, there's something wrong with me, like I'm always laughing. Like, if you say something that is like semi funny, I will laugh. or like I'm just I'm like a really, I don't know, I just feel like laughing is like such a good thing. Like, why would you not want to laugh all the time? Because especially when you're down, it stops you from feeling down, and that can tend to happen a lot. Like, especially when you like you're the last child and you're like bored all the time, you just look at stuff that make you laugh, watch a comedy or something, like be happy, because it's not all the time I can get out either. Because I am not 18 yet, so I can't even go out and have a drink. Yes, hunty, we can't do that. I'd probably also say my ideal partner is to be someone that is understanding and loves to listen, because I can talk, like I can talk for ages, and editing videos is longer than you guys think, because I can talk. Once I get into the flow, I can talk, like, you know what I mean? I am quite a talker. So, you know, you guys want to hold a conversation, just let me know that you came from my channel and we can hold a conversation. You know what I mean? I love a good conversation. I love a good debate. If there's something we have in common, like, for example, anime. I love watching anime. We can debate. Like, I'm not a fat anime fan. I haven't watched all the stereotypical animes like Naruto and Dragon Ball Z and Attack on Titans and all that, but I have watched some of them, like Death Note. I think I've watched three episodes, I can't even remember. Full Metal Alchemist and stuff like that. Baki is on my list, One Punch is on my list. I haven't watched them yet, not gonna lie. So now we're baking, so we're gonna let this sit for a little bit, and while we are doing that, we're gonna do our eyebrows. Copyright. Okay guys, so while my face is baking, we are going to do the brows. Guys, my routine is all over the place, but we move, and I haven't been listing all the products I'd be using, but we move. Today I'm gonna use my small eyebrow brush. It's very, very tiny, do you see that? And it's edged. I'm gonna be using this one instead of the one I've got here, because this one's actually like better bristled, so I'm gonna use this one today. I'm also going to be using the Kiko Lasting Eyebrow Gel. I think this is 05. So if you guys like want to know the shade. I don't know the colours to everything. This is also the Sleek Eyebrow Palette. Brown Kit Medium 821. I kind of mix this with a bit of the shadow. And then because it's like pasty, I mix it with the Kiko. And it like makes the best colour ever. And then I leave that brush there and I get my little 99p Body Collection light brown pencil. And I outline and like semi fill in my brows, because it helps get the shape better. Like, look at that. Where's it gone? Okay. So while that's happening, we're gonna do it. Excess powder. And the next question is the age I had my very first date. I think I was 16 when I had my very first official date. I was in year 7 when I had my very first boyfriend. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not good with that. Oh, I was this age in year 7, like, I'm not good with that. And yeah, I had my very first date. He was a dark-skinned Jamaican-Irish boy. He is really nice, but we broke up because I felt like he was putting on a front for his friends. I felt like he was changing a bit. And I guess I just wasn't his type. Eventually, like, I feel like he was falling for this other girl who was a lot older than me. I don't think I was quite the one to attract anybody in school years. Like, I was kind of like the loud, crazy one. The one that everyone's just like, yeah, she ain't ever finna get a boyfriend. She's lonely as hell. Kind of thing, do you know what I mean? I'm quite outgoing when you get to know me. I can be quite loud. And I get that from my dad. I'll be honest, I get that from my dad. He is quite the talker, quite the loud guy, quite the, like, center of the party, if that's what you wanna call it. And yeah, sometimes I like to just touch up the outline of my eyebrows, because when I wipe off the powder, I kind of like to semi-spread it across my face, and I feel like the line is not sharp enough. I'm actually the biggest eyebrow freak. Like, I have to make sure that my lines are, like, there, invisible, like. I am going to conceal my brows and my eyelids, and I'm gonna start doing my eyeshadow. After a breakup, do you prefer to be alone or do you prefer to be with friends? To be honest, I do prefer to be alone for a bit, but I would much prefer to be around friends, just because I can tend to be alone for a bit and then, like, get so used to it, I seclude myself away for a bit. I do feel like I'm the type that would want to be like, yo, like, let's go, let's get out. I need to take my mind off this stuff. But even when I come home, it's just like, you're still, like, in your feelings, do you know what I mean? I personally feel like breakups are actually the worst thing ever, because, like, sometimes y'all will break up and not talk ever again. And one thing I hate to do, and I don't know if this is a good thing in other people's eyes, but one thing is that I like to do, not hate to do, sorry, that I do all the time, is I try to be, I guess you could say, friends with the person after. So that it's a mutual, like, friendship. I feel like a lot of girls, some girls can't do it and other girls can. I feel like being friends before a relationship is a big thing for me, because then you're, like, building up something more than just dating. Do you know what I mean? And then you kind of have, like, more respect for each other, and then you can, like, still be calm if y'all don't want to date no more or whatever the reason was. If it's a, like, he cheated on you or some like deep stuff, then I get it. But if y'all just simply maybe not feeling it, or you just want to, like, I guess, hoe about or whatever the reason is, honey, like, do you know what I mean? Like, you do you, but, like, I prefer us to be calm, because I feel like it's just better that way. Because going through a breakup, maybe, I don't know if this is for boys and girls, but on my experience, I'd just say when you are not talking to someone and y'all are going through a breakup, it's a lot harder, because for me, just because I feel like when y'all are talking, like, you can still be cute with each other a bit, you know, like, and then slowly just literally be friends. And if y'all had a good vibe, why should you be like, not petty, I don't think petty is the word, but why should y'all both be like ignorant towards each other and then stop that friendship just because you're not in the feeling central of it anymore? Do you know what I mean? And like, obviously some girls, I guess, can't control themselves around their exes and they kind of just be like, oh my god, I want him, he needs to come back to me now, kind of thing. And I guess if you're like that, then you know to like not do that. Do you know what I mean? But otherwise, I kind of feel like I don't see the problem. I don't see why I should stop being your friend because of some dumb shit, because we're not talking. Like, I'm sorry, what? It's so stupid. It's just stupid. Like, if we had a good friendship, why not? We can still have jokes, banter. I mean, if not, y'all just need to stay mutual. Like, know your limits as well, because sometimes friendships can go a bit too far. Like, I'm not talking like friends with benefits, I'm friends, straight friends, because we ain't about that life, honey. Light blue, that's not a glitter in this palette. So what I'm gonna do is compact this at the front and then blend it out to like a blacky brown and see how this goes, because I'm not really a blue person, but it does go in my hair, so let's go. Is another question. I'd probably say I've always wanted happiness. I don't feel like I've ever been like at a point in my life where I'm like happy. I'm not gonna lie, I do feel like I find happiness when I am in relationships, just because I don't know, I feel like more whole as a person. Like, I can express myself also through you, and like, you're like mentally something that's pushing me and you don't even know it, like pushing me to be better. And that's a good thing, but also a bad thing, because I am the massive, like, massivist, is that even a word? Massivist, what? Procrastinator. When I'm not in a relationship, and that is super bad, because like most of your life you're not gonna be in a relationship, like, until you're older. Do you know what I mean? So procrastinating just because you don't got a man, don't do that, honey. Don't be like me. I got this from Technique. It is the golden one. Okay guys, so this is the finished look. To be honest, I like it and don't like it. Like, I kind of don't know how to feel. I'm not really a blue person, so like, this is new to me. Obviously there's blue in my hair, but it's black at the back. And of course my hair is orange. I normally go for like maybe light browns or like brown looks, but this is the finished look. I will insert some snaps here. Okay, so thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you liked the look. You know, let me know in the comments if there's any other look you want me to do. You know, maybe I could try something. I think I did a Valentine's Day look, but I didn't film it. I didn't record it. I should have, because why not? Like, am I weird? I don't know how to feel, to be fair. And then my baby hairs are not helping. Like, what is this? Okay guys, so that is the end of today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed. I will see you guys next time. I love you guys so, so much. Bye.
Yeah, this kitty busting a knot. You gonna let me touch it or not? Yeah. I promise you gon' love it a lot. I can hit it for months till you get the fussin' a lot. What's good? We gon' need some more liquor. Now here by myself, the bros with them. Feeling very important. Yeah, those my bottles of sparklers, X-Core, and now pull up. I just bought a section.